KLING AI is a powerful text-to-video and image-to-video generator that was just released, and using it feels like being in Inception, in which everything from the mundane can become surreal, and you never really know how grounded a scene is until it fully plays out. Here, you're the architect, and you can direct any scene to be anything. At the moment, it's free to sign up, but you only get a few generation credits, so today I'm gonna generate some videos, use up some of my credits, that way you can determine whether or not this is an app that is worth trying for you, and you can see some of the limitations and where it really excels at. I'm gonna be going over some tips and tricks that I found. We're gonna be trying out some of the text to video, the image to video, and really diving in and pushing KLING to its limits. I'm super excited, I know you are too. All right, let's go. So for a little context, we've covered other AI video generators before, like Runway's Gen 3 Alpha, OpenAI's Sora, Pika Labs, and even Luma Labs' Dream Machine. So this release is just one of the many video generators out there, but it's also one that I've been most excited about, and it's been the most difficult to get access to until now. The reason being is that this one is made by a Chinese AI company, and before it was just not available to those who are not inside of China. So today, I'm super excited to make this video and dive in and see how well KLING can actually make some stuff, because I've been seeing a lot of impressive generations coming out from the community. Okay, so this is what it looks like when you first sign into KLING, and you instantly get 66 credits, which will expire within 24 hours. So not a lot of time to get a trial period. And that's why we're making this video. That way you can get a sense as to where this AI really excels at and where it really struggles, so that you're not just wasting your time and energy and money. So let's hop right into this. The first thing that you're gonna see is that we can also generate AI images, but that's not as interesting because there are plenty AI image generators. The real winner here that most people have been excited about is the AI video generator from KLING. And we can take a look at some of the generations in the gallery here. You can see that it really excels at taking an original image and turning it into a full video. So it takes this and changes it into a model filming a commercial, smiling, hair blowing in the wind, and it definitely looks believable. However, if you take a look at some of the surreal aspects, such as a hunting dragon, flying sand, and a fantasy film, and it really does struggle a bit here because it is this slow motion kind of warping looking effect, which is not that believable compared to some of the human subjects here. So another thing that it also does well is animals. So we have this cat wearing an astronaut helmet. This does look believable, but not too much motion here. Whereas something like this camera looking down at a volcano is very impressive because we get so much details in here. A lot of the physics are getting shown, and this is some of the generations that I think KLING is really beating out some of the competitors like Pika Labs and Runway at the moment. Here's another awesome example of KLING AI's capabilities, to where you can see this is the original image of a dog in a pool swimming, and then it actually generated the video of the dog swimming. Now, not everything is perfect, but it does look very convincing. So let's go ahead and test this AI out for ourselves. I'm gonna go all the way up here to the AI videos tab and click on this. And you're gonna see that we have the text to video options here, as well as the image to video right next to it. Text to video, we can describe whatever prompt we want to use for the image. And then we have these additional settings such as creativity and relevancies. We have a standard mode and a professional mode, with the professional mode being locked to an upgrade to premium. So let's just go ahead and keep it to standard at the time being. And then we can also change the length of the generations. Using a shorter length will save more credits, whereas using a longer time, such as 10 seconds, we'll use up more credits for this. For the frame ratios, we can change it to a 16:9 or a 9:16 or even a 1:1. So a lot of flexibility here compared to some of the other AI generators. Another feature that we have is the ability to control the camera movement in the shots, which we've seen in other AI video generators as well. And at the bottom, we also have a negative prompt, which is optional. And this is typically where people may put in keywords that they don't want to see, such as distortion or disfigured, low quality, grainy footage, things like that. So let's go ahead and start off first with the image to video. I'm gonna use an image that I've generated from Midjourney. So I'm gonna use this image generated from Midjourney, which is a beautiful woman wearing a yellow dress standing in front of a huge, larger than life yellow flower. Anyways, I'm gonna plug in this same prompt into the image and prompt area here. So let's drag in the image, and then here I can just paste in the prompt, and let's leave all of the settings to default and hit generate, which you can see is going to use up 10 credits. Now at the moment, we're already at about 4 or 5%. So I'm going to go ahead and pause this because I think it's going to take a few minutes to finish generating. Wow. Okay. And in 5 minutes, we have a finalized generation from KLING. And I got to say, this looks pretty impressive. One thing to note is that I am noticing a bit of artifacting around the eyes and around the hands. So I am wondering if this is just a matter of it being in the standard mode, which it does say is a faster generation speed, whereas the professional mode would prioritize visual quality. So that could be a little issue here when not signing up for a premium plan. But at the moment, this is a really, really impressive generation just based off of that single image and the prompt. I gotta give this a solid 8 out of 10 here. It's really impressive. So let's go ahead and try out something a little bit more difficult for it. So this is an awesome generation that I have for Midjourney, which is a behind the scenes image of Rick essentially on a movie production set while he's awaiting a camera crew. So let's use this image as well as the prompt and plug this into KLING AI and see how well it does. Now, some of the things that I think it's gonna mess up on is the fact that this is not an anatomically correct human. This is a little bit of an interesting claymation mixture style here. So maybe it's gonna mess up on the hair fibers a little bit. I have no idea where it's gonna take this, but let's go ahead and see what it does. Okay, and we're leaving all of the settings at their default again and hitting generate, which is gonna use 10 credits. Okay, so we have the final generation here, and I gotta say, this is a weird video. Yeah, it's pretty cool. He does not have any movement of his mouth or his eyes, which is very jarring. And then it also adds in this other person, which is a little creepy into the scene. But I gotta say, I appreciate that it has at least a solid 1 to 2 seconds of usable movement here in the video footage tour. You just left it at this here. It does feel like this is a short scene, like maybe he's reacting to something. I gotta say, this one is also maybe a 7 out of 10 here because we don't have as much usable footage as we did with the other generation. But it's better than I did think it was gonna do. I thought it was gonna mess up on the hair, but the hair looks completely fine, whereas it's the face that is the weirdest part of this all. Let's go ahead and try out something else. Another one that I'm super excited to try out, where we went from a human subject with a little bit of a surreal element to a cartoon claymation animation in a real world setting, which is a very difficult thing for it to do, I can imagine. But let's do something that is fully out of this world. Okay, so this one was inspired by the Planet of the Apes movies, except if it wasn't an ape and instead if it was a nice red panda. So here we're gonna use this image. So let's plug this into KLING, do the same process as before, and again, leaving all the settings to default. So let's see what it creates for a cinematic action shot of a red panda king wearing tribal headwear, surrounded by a colony of apes and pandas lunging towards the front view. Yeah, there's a lot of details in this. I'm not even sure how it's gonna handle. Not even doing any prompt cleanup whatsoever. We're literally taking this directly from Midjourney and plugging it into KLING for a direct comparison to see how it does. Yo, okay, this is freaking sick. This is so cool. I was not expecting this at all. It even added in elements where the original Midjourney prompt had forgotten. So I love that it goes from this close up into this wide frame shot, which it shows the gorillas surrounding our red panda king. Now I do notice again a bit of artifacting, some little mess ups here and there if you look too closely, but then again, we are on the standard mode and I am really impressed with what they considered to be their lower quality results. So this is super impressive, just mind blowing. I gotta give this one a solid 9 out of 10 here. This is so good. All right, let's go ahead and keep going. So here I wanna plug in an image that does not have a distinguishable singular character as its main focus. Instead, we have this large sweeping cinematic shot of a futuristic cyberpunk ocean city. There's a lot of details in here, so I'm really curious to see how it comes out with the AI from KLING. Another thing to note about this is that it does have a bit of an artistic styling put onto it, so it's not entirely photorealistic. It does look like it is a bit of an illustration at the same time. Well, let's go ahead and see how well it does anyway. So I'm gonna take the same prompt again and let's hit generate. Wow, I gotta say, this is stunning. It looks so impressive. Now, obviously there are some artifacts and it does look a little bit lower resolution than I'd like it to be, but for creating the scene, having these birds flying, different cyberpunk vehicles flying, the boats here interacting with the water and leaving trails, even though there's a little bit of weirdness going on here, all of it still looks pretty good if you step back a solid 5 feet. So it's not perfect for a cinematic setting, but for something on Instagram or something very quick and possibly as a segue point for some more complex compositing, I think this is gonna work really well. And that's why I gotta give this a solid 9 out of 10. Great job, KLING. Now we only have 26 credits left, so let's go ahead and test out just the text to video option. Let's use the same prompt as before, except let's not use the image at all and see what it generates. I'm actually going to delete a little bit of this because I feel like I want to focus more on large buildings emerging from the ocean. I think that would make for a compelling shot. Let's leave all these settings to the default. Okay, so this is what it created. Now, I gotta say, this is not what I was expecting. I do think it did not follow the prompt so well in terms of it being futuristic and cyberpunk. However, we do get a very realistic ocean city with large buildings, and it is in the middle of the ocean, so I gotta give it props for this. However, I do love the way that it generated the video based off of the image prior to this when we combined it with Midjourney. So for the text to video option, I gotta give this one a 7 out of 10. It's still an awesome video, but just not stylistically what I was hoping for. Okay, and last but not least, we're gonna try out this cinematic shot of a futuristic movie set with a crew building a lush jungle made of neon plants with a portal to another world in view, and so on. This is a highly detailed prompt. There's so many different elements going on in this image, so I'm very curious to see how well KLING does. So let's go ahead and click generate, which will use up the final remaining credits. And I like that they give you 6 more credits, which will expire within 24 hours, knowing very well that 6 credits is just 4 credits away from actually being able to generate anything here. So not a fan of their shady business tactics. Okay, and I think we may have found where this AI does not do well, because this generation is very strange, very glitchy, and is not that much better than some of its competitors. So I gotta say, I think Luma Labs definitely killed it and made a much better scene than what we're seeing out of KLING AI for this. So one thing to keep in mind, it does not do these surreal, highly detailed scenes well just yet. And you're probably better off sticking to things like characters, ultra wide, large landscapes, and definitely nothing that has to have way too many details in it and too much styling going on. Another thing to note is that if you have human subjects, it probably is gonna handle them much better than some of the animated and cartoony stylized counterparts. If you enjoyed checking out KLING AI, I highly recommend you check out this other video in which we talk about WebSim, which is an awesome AI that lets you generate websites on the fly with just text prompts. It is super powerful, a whole lot of fun, and we get to exploring so many amazing creations with it. Anyways, thanks for watching. I hope to catch you all on the next one. Until next time, peace.